Hi everyone, and welcome back to Mike's VR Corner. Previously we reviewed the AMVR Oculus Touch Grip Extender Handles, and sadly the review didn't go very well. They kind of make the Oculus Touch Grips better, but also make it top heavy. So when you're playing in-game and Beat Saber, for example, which is what they were designed for, they make the experience quite tiring because everything's top heavy with your Oculus Touch controllers quite high above. Now, towards the end of that video, I did say modification could be a key on these actual devices, and I did look at them and think to myself, it wouldn't be that hard to do. So I will show you what I have achieved on these devices. So there we have a modified extender handle on the Oculus Touch controller. Now, as you can see, it fits my hand so much better than it previously did. Now, let's have a little flashback to how big these handles previously were. So, as you can see, that's it in my hand currently. Now, if you add that to the bottom, so you would be holding them, and your Oculus Touch controller would be that far away from your hand, which means it's pretty much very, very top heavy, which is what you don't want when you're swinging it around fast. It makes the experience very uncomfortable and actually slows you down in a way. So without further ado, we're going to talk about the modification. Now, modification's very simple to do. It took me a couple of tries to actually get it to the point where I liked it. But I'm quite happy with how it's turned out now. So, just under here, this actual sponge grip is glued in four places. You'll find it glued at the top on either side, and at the bottom on either side. So, and it's very simple just to work off. All you have to do is just peel the grip back a little bit gently, and just let the glue be peeled away. And once you get it to a point when you've undone all of the parts where it's glued, the handle just twists off, or the grip just twists off, leaving you the exposed plastic. Now let's remind ourselves. So, as you can see, this is where this will show you exactly how it's been glued. So you would have two at the top, and you can't see the bottom bit because it's currently attached, and you have two at the bottom. Now, the actual shaft of the handle is joined to the cup just here. So what you need to do is, well, what I did, I just placed pressure on this location and it just pretty much snapped away. It was quite a clean snap, but if you want to be more precise, at the time I really didn't care because of the cost of them, that you could saw it off and have a cleaner mark, or cleaner line that you can actually join up to. Now, once you get to that point, we want to keep the bottom of the shaft. Now, this bit that's being cut off is actually the top, so originally, this would have been up here. So, joined there with this bit here attached to the cup. We want to retain the bottom side. So, hold the actual grip in your hand attached to the Oculus Touch controller, and just measure how long you would like it to actually cover your hand properly so you can actually grip it without there being too much or too little. So once you've done that, you want to cut off the access from the top, okay, not the bottom, because we're keeping the bottom. So you want to cut off the access from the top. Now, I use the saw for this. You can use a cutting disc, you can use a coping saw, anything you wish, as long as it is a quite clean mark. Now, once you have that, what it will expose is the inner workings of the actual device. Now, there is a plunger inside these, which moves up and down, and connected to that plunger is a piece of string, which connects to the little kind of plug that goes into the Oculus Touch. Now, we want to retain all of that apart from this little tiny piece of string, because that's useless to us now, because we've been modifying the length of the screw as well, the screw device here at the back, because we're using that as a grip now instead of an adjustment. So Once you have it apart, you will see, which I'm going to put some pictures up now, you will see that there is the quite long screw shafts, which we would want to make to the same size as the shaft that you've cut to size. And you will see the inside plunger with the string that's connecting to it. What we'll be then doing is picking up your wrist strap string, because it's important, because it's black and it looks better than using any other colour. And we'll just be taking it apart. So this is the wrist strap that originally come with the actual extender handles, and we'll be taking the knot out from the actual bottom and taking the little adjustment tab off it and using that in place of the yellow string. Now you can see how the yellow string is connected. It's a notch that's holding it all together, so basically you want to replicate this kind of thing. So thread the black string through, tie a knot in the end so it doesn't go all the way through, then put it through the plunger that's inside the handle and have it come straight out the bottom. I'll throw a picture up to make it so you can see what it looks like. And then what you want to do is tie the rest of the string, well, after you put the little adjustment back on it again, through the original hole it attached to, but only one part of that string, as you can see from the picture. Now, the next bit is the glue. Now, as I've said previously, Loctite super glue, the gel super glue variant of it, it's perfect for this. It allowed me to fill in any gaps which was there, and believe me, there were some gaps the way I did it. For you, it may be completely different and you may want to use some other glue that you're quite comfortable with. But for me, the Loctite Super Glue Gel Glue is perfect for this. Now, once you've let that set, and believe me, please let it set, and you can then slide your grip back on to the actual shaft and just put it up over where the glue was, and that will just hide the glue as well and it make it look more OEM for the manufacturer, of course, not Oculus, and that glue it in place so it doesn't move about. Now, as the screw shaft has to be adjusted, you have to cut off any excess from the actual length. Otherwise, you're not going to be able to screw it back in again. Now, all I did was line it up to the actual handle and see exactly how much I wanted it to be, and then cut off any excess. So once you've done that, it's just a matter of it all clamping down on itself. So it's no longer using the plunger inside to adjust. You can hear that's nice and free inside there. But once you screw this in place, it'll keep it in place for you, because it'll act as a clamp. So we're going to screw this right up. Make sure the Oculus is in there. Make sure the string is pulled tight. And you screw it up until it clamps in place. And that's, ladies and gentlemen, is your modification for the AMVR Oculus Touch Grip Extenders. And it's so much better. So if you like this video, then check out some of my other ones. If you want to see more of what I do, subscribe. It's early days, so you never know what's going to happen. But anyway, thanks for visiting, and hopefully catch you again later. Thank you.